What we just said is a lot deeper than it sounds. Let me back up a little bit to tell you what makes a successful person in this world. In Judaism, we come into this world to become like God. That's what we're here for. God has midot, characteristics that we say in the Yag Midot every day. El Rahum Vehanun Erech Apaim Brav Hesed Emet. Hashem is giving, Hashem is compassionate, Hashem is Emet, is true. Our purpose and mission in life as an image of God, Tzelem Elohim, we are here to be like Hashem. That we look and we follow and we do exactly what He does. Because that's the opportunity granted to us in this world. Hashem says, the greatest gift that I can give you is to give you the chance to be like me. There's no greater being in the world than the creator of the world. Hashem puts us in this world with the opportunity to be like Him. That's the greatest gift that God can give us. Probably the most clear midah that we see from the Creator is His midah of chesed, of giving. After all of us in this room are a product of God's kindness. He made us from nothing. He made the world from nothing. Any pleasure you ever had in your life is only due to God giving you that pleasure. Whether He gave you the apple or the orange, or He gave you the mouth to enjoy it. Any pleasure that you can imagine is only because God gave it to you. That's obvious to all of us. And this we see all day long. God is the giver. That's how we know Him. Rav Chesed. That means we come into this world to be givers. The opposite of a giver is a taker. Someone who only takes. God never takes. God is perfect. God only gives. That's why Shlomo HaMelech says, Vesone matanot. Someone who hates to take, he hates gifts. Yehyeh. That person will live a great life. Because if you're a person looking for gifts, if you're looking for handouts, then you're the opposite of God. Because God doesn't take. God only gives. He's a giver. Which means one of the greatest ways to be like God, if not the greatest, is to be a giver and not a taker. To give others more than you take from others. Now, sometimes taking from others is like giving. It's possible. Sometimes if someone buys you a gift, one day your wife will buy you a gift, and you'll say, no, no, no. Shlomo says, Sone matanot yahyeh. I'm sorry, I can't accept that gift from you. That's a mistake. Because sometimes when someone buys you a gift, and you accept that gift, that makes them feel good. That they were able to do something for you. So in essence, when you take, you're actually giving. That's okay. That's not called taking. It all depends on your intention. If sometimes you take because you want the other person to feel good that he gave, that's called giving. So it's not always in the physical act of who's transferring. Is it going this way or that way? Sometimes it's going your way and it's called giving. But our mission in life is to be a giver. And the opposite and the most destructive life is a life of taking, a life of selfishness, a life where it's all about me. This is not only in the relationship between us and God, it's in all of our important relationships. A marriage between a husband and a wife is built on this principle. If they both give to each other, it will be a great marriage. Literally, a marriage made in heaven, like God. If they are takers and looking to take from the marriage, whatever they can, the husband's looking to take the most that he got from his wife, and she also from him. This is a recipe for a disaster marriage. Now you should know that every relationship has a giver and a taker. The woman gives a husband and he takes. The husband gives his wife and she takes. So you have giving and taking. But the question is, where's your focus? When you come into a marriage, are you focused to give? And your taking is part of giving? Or are you focused on taking? And your giving is really to take. It's a very big difference. I'll give you an example. Meaning, when you do something for your wife, are you doing it so she could do it for you? So you're really giving, but you're not giving. It's like going to the store and buying a slice of pizza. So one might say, look, here's a guy giving money to the person behind the counter. What a giver he is. He's like God. He just goes and gives money to him. And guy tells you, no, 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 hello. That's not what he's doing. He's not giving. He's taking. He wants pizza. So he has to give in order to take. So there's an example of someone giving something, but really he's taking. A person selling pizza or selling food for Shabbat. Is he a giver or is he a taker? I have a store. And I sell all types of Shabbat food. People come in and they buy fish, they buy kibbeh, they buy laham ajin, they're buying. Am I a giver or am I a taker? One guy will come into the store and say, hey, what a giver this guy. Look at him giving out food to every house in this community. He's giving them kibbeh, he's giving them laham ajin, he's giving them wine. What an unbelievable giver. This guy's like God. And the other guy says, what are you talking about? Not a giver. Don't you see people giving him money? He doesn't care to give them. He just wants money. So is he a giver or is he a taker? What do you say? Well, on one hand, he's giving. On the other hand, he is taking money. So what is he? So it all depends on his intentions. If really he wants to give people food for Shabbat, he loves to give food, he loves to have people enjoy, and he's servicing them. He knows he can't survive if they don't pay him. He has to live. How's he going to come back next week and give again? He can't live without taking money. So he takes money to live. But really, he wants to give them. That guy's a giver, even though he's taking money. But if he doesn't care about the people at all, he doesn't care if they eat, he doesn't care if all the food goes in the garbage, he doesn't care. All he wants is your money. Now he knows you're not giving him money for free. So he has to give you something in return. But his giving is really taking. So it's all based on the intentions. It's not the physical act. So let's go back to husband and wife. Husband and wife. A husband does something for his wife. Is he giving or taking? She's giving, he's taking. She's taking, he's giving. What is it? It's all in the kavana. What's your intention when you do something for someone else? Are you investing in him giving you? So you're a taker, you're selfish, you're the opposite of God. Or are you a giver? And this is in every relationship. You could be a rabbi teaching. Are you a giver or are you a taker? If you're a rabbi, are you a giver or a taker? It depends. On one hand, you're giving Torah. You're giving wisdom. It's a great chesed. On the other hand, you're getting, maybe you're getting paid. Maybe you're getting respect. So now, are you a giver or a taker? There's both elements here. What does it depend on? Your intention. If you come in to teach and say, listen, I'm here to teach. I'm here to give. I can't survive if I don't get paid. How am I going to live? I got to pay the bills. So I have to get paid. But really, I'm here to give. That's a giver. The rabbi who cares, you know what? I got to live. I need money. So how am I going to make money? How am I going to do it? I got to teach. That's a taker. The difference between the two, which on the surface, it looks the same. They're both giving and they're both taking. But the end product of the one who has intentions to give is like God. He's godly. And the one who's doing it for the money, he is the opposite of God. He becomes a taker. And that is not a life worth living. Sone matanot yahyeh. We're here in this world to give. In every relationship that we have. You have friends. You're not married yet. But you have friends. This relationship with your friend, maybe you have two close friends, or three close friends, or one close friend. How does it work with you and your friend? Think for a minute. Because whatever you are with your friend today, take your top one or two friends, that's what's going to look like when you get married. How does it work with you and your friend? Are you a giver to your friend? Or are you a taker from your friend? Now, I'm sure between you and your friend, sometimes you give and sometimes you take. Sometimes he drives you, sometimes you drive him. Sometimes he lends you, sometimes you lend him. Sometimes you help him, sometimes he helps you. So are you a taker or are you a giver? How is the relationship between you and your friend? It all depends. Do you give because you're a giver? And sometimes you have to take? Or do you give because you want to take back one day? You know why I'm helping my... You know why I'm driving you today? Because one day, you're going to drive me. You know why I'm lending you today? Because one day, you're going to lend me. You know why I'm helping you today? Because one day, I need your help. You know what that's called? That's called a taker. Try that. Maybe with friends, you can get away with it. You try that at home with your wife, one day soon, you're in for a big disaster. You're in for some roller coaster ride. And it's not going to end up with exhilaration like Great Adventure. It's not like that. It's going to be a roller coaster that keeps going up and down and doesn't stop. So you got to practice today. You have to look at your close relationships and ask yourself, am I a giver or a taker? Look at the relationship between you and your father, or your father, and or you and your mother, your parents. Are you a giver to your parents? Or are you a taker from your parents? No question you take from your parents. Because you have to. Because you're not working. Because you need them. And they're happy to give you. But is that the essence of your view of this relationship? When you look at your mother, do you see food? When you look at your father, do you see $100 bills? Is that what your father represents to you? Money, a car, your mother, oh, there's clothing, there's food, there's dinner, there's someone to pick me up. How do you view your mother? And how do you view your father? Are they just like, you know, vending machines? When you go to the vending machine, how do you see the vending machine? You don't look at, oh, I give the vending machine. You don't give nothing to the vending machine. You look to take from the vending machine. What do you have today to offer? When you look at your parents, do you want to give them? Do you say, what can I do for my mother? Can I write her a note? Can I buy her flowers? Can I tell her thank you? Can I go somewhere for her? My father maybe needs my help. Maybe he wants a cup of coffee. Maybe he wants me to go down the block for him. Or do I just look at them as a vending machine? My opinion, and don't get offended, I believe everybody in this room, if not everybody, it's 99%, look at your parents as vending machines. They're vending machines. They're just live vending machines. It's all what I can take from them. Once in a while, I gotta put a quarter in. You know, the vending machine, if you don't put a quarter, it's not gonna work. So once in a while, I gotta do the right thing. But ultimately, it's a relationship of taking. At our age, we need to start changing that. Because this is not a healthy relationship from our end. Yes, when they give us and we take, we should be happy that they feel good about giving us. But our mindset should be, what can I do for my parents? This is real life training to become like God. How to look at your friends, how to look at your parents, how to look at your rabbi. Our success in life is going to be this mindset in anything that we do, whether it's in business, whether it's in Torah, whether it's social, whether it's family, marriage, children, in anything, any relationship, anything you do in life, you're going to have this question. Giver, taker. God, not like God. Success, failure. Yihye, yamut. Real life, or life not worth living. In anything you do, religious, not religious, it makes no difference. In everything you do, that's the question. Are you giver or taker? Rate yourself. Take a piece of paper. Say, with my relationship with my mother, am I giver or taker? Taker, T. Just write T, it's easier. With my relationship with my rabbi, giver or taker? T. With my relationship with my friend, Yosef? T. How about this guy? Rate yourself. Rate your top 10 relationships and ask yourself, are you giving or taking? Probably your age, you'll have mostly T's. I don't think you'll have even one G. But that's why we're here. We're here to start changing that pattern. It's got to start to change. Because like I said, you take this formula and fast forward 5 years from now, I'm not saying even now it's so good, but you fast forward 5 years from now, you're a disaster. You're not going to make it. Meaning you're not going to be able to enjoy your life. Because you'll never enjoy your life being a taker. Because taking is selfish. And selfishness is the opposite of God. Godly means to give. And every relationship that we have is built on giving and taking. It's always that way. There's someone giving and someone taking. And the question is, where's your head? Where's your mind? What's your intention?